GAA Handball Show. Welcome back to the GAA Handball Series as we continue our focus on the international game of one-wall handball, which is sweeping across Ireland and around the globe. It was a rain that washed away, rinsed out the colours of your eyes, putting the gun down on the bedside table. I must have realised it wasn't the rain that made the difference. I could have sworn it wasn't me, yet I did it all so coldly. Last time we brought you the stars of the international game, with focus on many of the rising young stars of today. In this episode, we maintain that interest, but we bring you some of the highlights from the many adult grades, including some of the more senior players of the sport who continue to excel from the benefits of the game.
I'd love to be here even as a spectator because I never saw as much enthusiasm for handball as there is at the moment, especially the new game, the one wall. And that's why one of the reasons why I came here.
Firstly, though, we take you to the far west of Ireland and the excellent promotion of the game on the Aran Islands, where Inishmore hosts a terrific social weekend tournament every year. Cool. I spend my time just thinking about you. Every single day, guess I'm really missing you.
And all those things we used to do. Hey girl, what's up? Well, I reckon to come up this more in while I'm enjoying the shot in the show. Come up this on the dog, will. Hulugrad of Fuija, Swaskadi, Dinis was Lashachto, Blian Gisha Gimortian, Mrogus, Fedigus, Holikinologus, Tagari Harkin Lisbeth Ledia.
Every my dad, so for me, that's a first sea, I guess, we more it, so women's challenge happened. Agus fi misio fwy cwjig, agus fi eim yn fwy cwjig ffresin, agus fi morti yn fwy cwjig ffresin.
Cerdd ta tarlw leis y glob di ar y mwyd na, ta glob bynnu hiw agus clor i hen le gob li yn ynnish. Agus ta swys le beidr, os gyn gos gwr gas o'r og y gymwyrt, ta harter scored in the first game with four work of raw camera if we lord ach arno tagalor lads in is tagalish ta agus veis opni on the jig gari jig special chin marim lori shin chiran ma khancho ach nin club bonichen achla gavlien agus the gairi gmal in the gas with is viral over ta kull gas ur in the lan gol himpul agus zero in the lord agus he's in the ball focus yet for Trapo, Galchisa Boro, Casabali Warion Skull, Casuas and I Bound Skull, as is Intokajo and Ruda, Mark Captain Gur, Intokan Sport and Leroy Lager, near which a general lay a piece of wall of the Leroy of the Tanan Club event.
The venue here is absolutely gorgeous and they looked after us so well, and I'll definitely come back next year.
This is what I suppose the one wall game is all about, just, you know, travelling all different parts of the country and play, you know, meeting people and playing games, you know, it's what it's all about.
Oh, it was
a great day for the kids. Fair Crowd, 6 years of age now, put on an exhibition in the under-10 plate, and they really enjoyed it. So it was a great weekend. Just to echo what Charlie said, this is what One Wall's about. Playing outside in May, it's fantastic. Brilliant. Can you meet me halfway? Meet me halfway. Right at the borderline is where I'm going away. For you, I'll be looking out. Night and day. Took my heart to the limit, and this is where I stay. I'd just like to welcome all the handballers here tonight. I hope you all had a great day here on the island. Hopefully it was a success, first time being here and everything. And I'd like to thank you all for coming out, because without you it wouldn't have happened. So thank you very much for all the support you gave.
You get that two dimensions. You get the competitive and the open grades, the A grades and the B grades. You get the competitive players, and then you get the players coming here for the fun, for the social aspect, to see the Aran Islands, to experience what Ireland life's like. Stones
taught me to fly. Back in Breaffy House Sports Arena, many of the Irish players are improving with every season, and the latest challenges against the Stars of USA and Puerto Rico certainly provide the greatest test possible. So it's not hard. When you blow like a cannon,
oh, still a little bit of your song in my ear. Still a little bit of your.
The men's open event served up some incredible sequences of play for the delighted crowds who thronged the courts to see the rip-roaring action at close range. So close that I can't see what's going on. Fight out. Stones taught me to fly. Oi. Love taught me to lie. Oi. Taught me to die. Cause it's not hard to fall.
Oi.
And I don't want to scare her. It's not hard to fall. In the ladies' event, 2010 champion Down's Lorraine Havern was hoping to continue her challenge for top honour with the full support of her extended family, all of whom were in action in a host of other grades too. You're insecure,
don't know what for. Usually a lot of us in our family, we all decided we all love handball, just One Wall especially. All the kids do, the young ones, and we just said that we'd all enter this year and come down for a big social event, you know, because it's a great tournament and has been for the last few years.
At the moment, actually, an Irish handball, as you did touch on it there, and Lorraine is one of the informed Irish players at present, isn't she? Mm-hmm.
I think Lorraine's strongest court of handball is actually One Wall. I know she plays a lot of it at home in Down, and I think it's her favourite. She'll okay, admit that herself, it's her favourite form of handball. You can see that on the court.
Yeah, and she chocolate Lorraine. My phone Lorraine, we made a cup of sugar, Nidal for chocolate. Yeah, and she chocolate. My smile of love the road, you know, smile of big emot and love the road. So good, come on, you got it wrong. To prove I'm right, I put it in a song. I don't know why you're being shy and turn away when I look into your eyes.
Rising Down star just found the USA champion Karen McConney too powerful on this occasion.
Yeah, this is a really impressive performance by Karen McConney in this second game. It's just now 1 point away from a place in the Ladies Open final. Have to take that one again.
I think Lorraine was too near the crowd there, was it?
But this has been really impressive here from Karen McConney. And a great way to finish off a fantastic performance.
Time, yeah.
Yeah, that was an outstanding performance by Karen McConney, especially in the second game.
Yeah.
Ireland's other remaining challenger, Roscommon's Mariana Rush, was also edged out in the second semi-final by Melendez of Puerto Rico.
serve by Lorraine, and she really pushed her back.
Yep. Up my world like
nobody else, the way that you feel. Michelle's got to move the ball. She's hitting it too much in the center. She needs to take Mariana off court.
She's making Mariana really move.
Yeah, and she does it. Yeah, yep. She brings it all the way to the left. Great shot by Michelle. She hits it nicely to the left and goes past Mariana.
So here is possible match point.
Deep serve and Michelle beats her. That's right, it's going to be Puerto Rico and the United States in the final.
The final clash of USA and Puerto Rico enthralled the crowd too with some amazing power play from the two competitors. You're in control, pressing pause on my heartbeat. Someone stole all the air, so I can't speak now. I know the chase is on.
I feel as though my time. This could go either way, Sophia. I mean, there's no question, isn't there?
Yeah, it's true. I mean, we just have to see who's going to really take the initiative. You know, Karen has a lot of experience. Her signature shot is the right kill shot. So, you know, I think she's going to be shooting for that. She knows she has to play well against Michelle. Michelle's very aggressive.
10 plays 11, just one in it again.
Wow.
And it's Michelle who always seems to sort of take a 3 or 4 point lead, but Karen keeps coming back. She can't shake her off at the moment.
No, she can't. She's going to have to. This is her nemesis right now.
So much as a psychological piece of game, especially for Michelle. Great shot by Michelle. And Karen is just 1 point away from winning not just this game or match, but the whole tournament. And that's going to be a replay. And
yeah.
She probably came into this whole tournament as favourite to win the whole thing,
yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
And she survived a couple of scares maybe along the way,
mm-hmm.
But she looks as if she's about to take the honours.
Yeah.
And Michelle misses, and that's the title goes to Karen McConney of the USA.
McConney emerged the victor in the end to become the first non-Irish player to win the event. Join us after the break when we will focus on the men's open event and take another look at GAA Handball's growth in areas where the sport has never previously been played.